Verano Muy Canale. Good morning, my channel. We are here on a gorgeous, sunny Saturday morning here at Penmar Park Golf Course. And today we're going to have a meeting with our councilwoman of Council District 11 Los Angeles. That's Councilwoman Tracy Park. And she's going to be meeting with us along with representative of the Street Services of Los Angeles to talk about the revitalized Rose Avenue project. For those of you who are not familiar with that, that is our former dirt path that we used to run around the golf course for the past 7 decades. It's been closed down for a couple of years now, fenced off, because it was Los Angeles's largest homeless encampment in closest proximity to houses. It was directly across the street from all the residents' houses, including myself, who I live in this neighborhood. We had over 132 campers over there living there full time, causing a lot of problems. So today they're going to talk about all the wonderful things they're going to bring to this revitalization project: the new bushes, the new trees, the decomposed granite, the flora and the fauna, the spotted butterflies. But I am here today to hold all people accountable, because I want the question, which is the elephant in the room, answered, which is, how are we going to stop the homeless encampment from returning once the fencing goes down over there? I want to know how we're going to prevent that from coming back. Right now in the park, we already have the 41.18, which is the LEMC special zoning that Tracy has put here for Penmar Park. The signs are up, and the enforcement started yesterday, August 9th. But as we look across the street right now into the park, here we are, and I see the same people that have been camping in this park for several weeks, if not months. So yeah, they're right here. They're in Penmar Park. They're camping there. That's full time. He got an RV across the street. That guy's been here for at least 8-9 months. Got his pickup truck behind him. So again, the burning question that I want answered is, great, the city's going to invest all this funds into building this wonderful revitalization here of the dirt path, which, to me, in my opinion, the dirt path met our needs. It allowed us to walk and jog around the golf course. I don't need you to pave it. I don't need you to put stones on it. I don't need you to put anything on it. I just need you to keep something off of it. That's mentally ill addicts who want to camp, cause crime, chaos, sell, use, smoke the narcotics, steal from the neighbors, make life a living hell here. Anyhow, meeting starts at 10 o'clock. I'm a little early, but here's our fenced off area that I'm talking about here. This is at the corner of Rose and Penmar, and it goes all the way up for 2 blocks to Rose and Frederick, and then it goes down Frederick Street over there. So this is the area here that we've got fenced off to keep the homeless from turning it into their campground again. And yeah, that's what we want to stop. We want to make sure that once this gets opened back up here and they repave it and add all the wonderful stuff. So we'll go to the meeting. We'll see what happens. And here are the special signs that have been posted all around the park. Special enforcement zone beginning on Friday, August 9th. No person shall sit, lie, or sleep in the public right-of-way within 500 feet of the golf course park here. So the signs are posted. You can see the blue there. That's the park, and the light blue all the way around it is the 500-foot zone. So that means all in the park and 500 feet around the park, that's the vicinity for all the neighbors, we are not supposed to have any campers. And that was started yesterday. So are they actually sending out any resources, or do we normally have to do our typical, which is we gotta call in and ask for some sort of coordination? What I'd like to see is daily enforcement here, because otherwise the campers just come here and they'll just camp until the police come, and then they vacate, and then they stay again for another couple weeks till the police or park rangers come back. And that's not exactly really enforcing any law, is it? So as you can see here, as we get closer, yeah, we got encampments. Stuff all screwing up out in the park here. So in fact, that is exactly what we don't want. The campers, they're here and they camp out. Now, for anybody who says, well, why don't you like them just camping there? That's because most of them are mentally ill with their addictions, and they bring their needles and other paraphernalia that the kids step on. They expose themselves. They sell and distribute and use narcotics. They have psychotic episodes, and they just make the park a generally an unsafe area to be in. And the park is for the public. It's not supposed to be the world's largest outdoor mental institution. So, yeah. Where do I want them to go? I want them to accept all the shelter housing. We spent over $1 billion last year in LA County on it. Let's start encouraging the people to actually go in there. Let's start using the care courts. If they're that addicted, they can't take care of themselves, to put them into the mental health housing. Okay, it's 9:45, time to go inside and get a seat here for the meeting. Okay, welcome neighbors here. Just put out a couple roses. We're gonna welcome the neighbors of the Rose Avenue Penmore Park neighborhood here.
Hey guys.
So we have a little bit of some swag here they're giving away. Tracy Park's got some stuff here. Tracy Park water bottle. Encouraging neighbors to sign in. You notice they've got some ivy here. Kind of reminds me of the ivy on the outfield of Wrigley Field. I don't know if that's for the Rose Avenue beautification project or if that's something just here for the Penmont Restaurant Event Center here. So here, right behind us, we've got the renderings here of the project limits. We're going to go here from Rose and Penmar. We're right here at the golf course and all the way down Rose Avenue. These are little bump outs for the trees. That's where they're going to plant new trees. This is a new crosswalk at Cortland, a new crosswalk at Penmar, and the project's going to go all the way down to Frederick Street. As you can see, they're going to use drought-tolerant planting, new curbs and ramps, street trees, new aggregate sidewalks, right? We've got pallet options, all kinds of bushes, moonlight grave, manzanita, lilac, cone bushes, baby rush, that's great. We're talking about the sidewalks here and the trees, the Chinese flame tree, the elegant water gum tree, the sweet bay tree, eastern rosebud. Okay, and now we've got the revitalization here. I see somebody walking. I see more people walking. Hey, there's me. There's Danny Slant riding his bike on the bike path. Cool. And what I noticed, there's an absence of campers. We don't want any campers. So let's make sure we bring this up here. Here's the existing path, right? It's dirt. We used to just run around it. Here's the other path on Frederick. We used to run around it. They're going to have ADA ramps. So essentially, they're turning the dirt path into a sidewalk. I want to make sure that the sidewalk doesn't soon become congregated with homeless campers. So we are here right in front of the Streets LA booth here at the Revitalize Rose project meeting that we're having here at Penmar Park. And why don't you tell us what we can do today?
Hi, I'm Joella Valdez from Streets LA, and we are here today to tell the community all about this great project that we're bringing to the area, Revitalizing Rose Avenue. If you want to learn more about the project, we're asking everyone to scan this QRC code, fill out the form, and you will get a chance to spin the wheel and win a prize.
Fantastic. All right,
let's see.
Hard hat, pen clip, tape measure, your choice.
Okay.
So I'm going to pay it forward. I'm going to give somebody the hard hat LA. The LA hard hat to the next person. Oh, that's super cute. And USB cables and little post-it notes and some tape measure and water bottles.
Uh-huh. Okay. And some magnet clips.
Okay. So Streets LA has been working very hard on this project here. We, the neighbors, are very, very happy to see something's going to happen with this. So we're very interested to hear what the presentation is going to be today. Thank you so much for telling us about these prizes and the QR code.
Thank you for coming.
Appreciate that. Thank you. So tell us who you are.
My name's Erica Moore, and I'm the Outreach Chair for the Venice Neighborhood Council.
Nice to see you here this morning here. And as you were just mentioning before I had the camera rolling, you were saying, hey, Danny Slant, I see your videos. You're making the videos of everybody in the neighborhood. She remembered me from the video I made of the neighbor who had her car stolen. She said, you know, I should get involved with Neighborhood Council.
Absolutely.
Although,
honestly, I'm having my hands full between my surgeries and things I've got going on and just running the channel. But I do want to encourage people who are in Venice to get involved with the Neighborhood Council, sign up, run for offices,
yes.
You know, get involved on the various committees so that we can basically have all of the thoughts and signatures needed to go over to Tracy Park and say, this is what our neighborhood wants here.
Exactly right. That's exactly the function of the Neighborhood Council. We make recommendations, and those recommendations are supposed to come from the stakeholders. So here today, what I have is our QR code. If people want to go onto our website and sign up to be on our mailing list, and so they're in the know of what's going on. Also, we have brochures that talk about, you know, getting involved. But what's really important is that people don't know about this, is that there are different committees, and there might be something that they feel very passionate about, that we have a committee that can facilitate their interest so they can get involved. It's, you don't have to be on the board, and you can come to those meetings, you can participate and take action on things that matter to you. We have a larger voice to the council member. Of course, individuals can go to the council member and she's going to be there for you. However, when it comes through a motion that is supported through the Venice Neighborhood Council, there's a little more teeth in it. We file a CIS, which is a community impact statement, and that's on file with the city. And that, again, is something that can be referenced in the future, that, hey, this is what the community felt, how they felt about this one issue. It also gives us affords us the opportunity to have a seat at the table when those issues come up and there's hearings. We actually have the opportunity to have a representative go and speak on behalf of that CIS, which you don't get when you call in for public comment. You get 1 minute, but we get a lot more time and we have a seat at the table.
Okay, I really appreciate you pointing that out, because I'll be honest, during prior administrations of our council person, they often ignored the Venice Neighborhood Council. We would have unanimous votes and say we didn't want things like bridge housing, and they said too bad, and they rammed it down our throats. My other complaint that I have is that people get to vote in these elections by calling themselves stakeholders. If you read the literature, if you own a horse or ride a horse in Venice, do you know that qualifies you as a stakeholder?
Yeah.
Now, I just laugh because I know there's not a lot of horse riding here, but I know in other communities there are. But to qualify for somebody who can vote, and oftentimes they used to bring busloads of people in to vote in of certain things. And I used to say, I say, I've been in this community for over 30 years. I don't know who you are. Most people recognize me. I'm pretty recognizable. I'm kind of a character. I'm a wacky guy. But anyhow, I still want to have people participate. I see the council and our current councilwoman is very receptive to working with the council and listening to the input. And I wasn't aware that city council on the issues allows you unlimited time to speak on the motions.
Well, so. It's not unlimited, but we have...
But more than the public comment.
Yes, we have an opportunity to talk, not just... We don't have to call in and just have that 1 minute and hopefully get chosen, because that's another thing. When people feel really passionate about a certain issue, a lot of people call in. Not everybody gets to have their voice heard, but because we filed a CIS, we get to have our voice heard. So it's very important.
I've been there for the 1 minute. I talk fast and I walk fast. You'd be surprised if I can get covered in a minute, but you get cut off. And again, I really appreciate talking this morning.
Absolutely.
Can tell us who you are one more time again?
My name is Erica Moore. I'm the Outreach Chair for the Venice Neighborhood Council. I'm actually looking for enthusiastic members who want to participate on my committee. It's doing outreach. It's making the VNC visible to others.
Let's
it's planning the, events
let's
and things
the,
like
let's
that.
Let's get the QR code for those.
Right there.
Scan that. Anybody can scan that here with the technology?
Yes, we also have a manual sign-up list that I'm happy to have people sign up on. Not everybody likes technology, and I'm down with that. We try to bring accessibility to everybody.
Old school. Pen and paper.
That's
you can
right.
get involved.
That's right. I like to say old school with the innovative twist. That's me. We do have an election coming up, though, this March,
okay.
And we want people to run. We want people to get involved. People, you know, you can become an at-large community officer. It's a really wonderful opportunity. That's what happened to me. That's the first position I got elected as, but then the person who was the outreach chair stepped down, and I ran for that position, and I elevated to that.
Okay.
So
now we see that we're filling up, so you're going to have a great
busy.
Opportunity to
That's
get some
right.
people on here. It's a pleasure. We'll give you a fist
Thank
pump.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for talking
Thank
with me.
You.
And check it out on the channel. It'll be up there later tonight.
Sounds good.
Thank
Bye-bye.
You. Bye-bye.
I'm really happy to see you, Danny. I really appreciate the work you do documenting all the many issues that we poor people in Venice face all the time, and you really help bring attention to them. So.
I appreciate that. Let me tell you, sometimes, especially lately, because I'm not riding my bike because of my shoulder injury, I'm not getting my daily exercise, it kind of gets a little depressing sometimes. So just to hear the encouragement news that people actually appreciate the videos that I'm doing and realize I am just one. What, something that's actually happened during the videos is so many people have reached out to me, and you realize we are a community. We are a strong community, and we're all suffering the same issues. Now I'm here today, and we're going to talk about the flora and the fauna and the spotted butterflies and the trees. But I don't want to swear, but quite frankly, I don't give a rat's arse about what you plant out here. I want the guarantees that that's not going to become the huge encampment in front of my home again.
And I have the same feeling you do, and I was just talking to someone from Street Services about the Frederick's Lane Park. How are you going to keep them from camping there? And I was told by one of the neighbors that they just put in a ban on any camping near this park.
Yeah, as of yesterday,
signage went up.
Yeah, it went up yesterday.
So the cops can just roll in there and say, yes. no camping or possessions 24/7. That's a hell of a step forward.
Yep, but I did just walk by the park as I came into this meeting today, and I don't know if you noticed, we got four guys camping in the corner right at Rose and Penmar. So obviously, I know it's early, it's only the second day of the signs, but I want enforcement. Why should it be me, the responsibility of a neighbor, to have to sit here and chase after law enforcement?
The problem with a lot of the younger officers is they just don't know that where the areas are that they can just simply say, you can't be here, if you don't leave, you're going to get a ticket or you're going to be arrested. Because it works near Gold's Gym.
Right.
There's nobody camping there because the cops have really enforced that. I wish they were quite so good at it along the boardwalk. But still, compared to Bonin's time.
Oh, yeah, it's night and day. I mean, the bar is set up. Tell us who you are.
Mark Ryavec.
Okay,
Mark. Stakeholders Association.
Exactly. Mark has been a super critical, important community member here, has done so much to help us here in this community. I just want to let our viewing audience know who he is. And
I helped get some of the money together for Frederick's Park.
Okay.
I put in the application for the funding for them to close a gap when they were short some funds.
And how did you get here today?
I rode my bike.
Exactly. He rode his bike. You know, my pet peeve about the Friday night concerts they have here where they pack these kids in. They all come up, they all drive, they drink and drive, they park in the neighborhood. I'm like, ride your bike, take a scooter, take an Uber, take a Lyft, take a shuttle. You know, they complain, oh, I had to park a mile away. That's how crowded it gets here. They have to park a mile away, but they're parking in front of the residents. Now, some residents don't have garage. Now, what are you going to do? So during the Friday nights, it's very difficult. So, you know, I like the concerts. I love the outdoor stuff. I love the, you know, the new usage of the golf course at night. But again, let's have consideration for the neighbors.
Well, they need to, you know, you ride on your bike or you come on a scooter, they should, you know, take a few bucks off your...
Okay, I mentioned that. How about a promotion with Lyft and Uber that says if you sign up with the QR code, your first ride to the concert is free. It's covered.
Well, that's one way to do it. The other one is for the restaurant to say, look, we'll take $5 off your bill.
Brilliant minds think alike. Mark, I really appreciate you talking to me. And right in the middle of the Revitalized Rose meeting, which the official presentation hasn't started, but I've been talking with many, many neighbors who know me from the neighborhood. The helicopter went overhead because our homeless campers in the park were fighting each other. Apparently there was an axe up in the air they were fighting, so the helicopter came over up ahead. And now we have LAPD. So yeah, I welcome this. This is what I want. I don't want to have it come down to their bashing each other in the head with axes, but yeah.
So we are in fact enforcing the 41.18 here. We've got LAPD in the park, which I like to see. We've got them, here they are. They are actually enforcing the law, enforcing the zone, telling these campers they must vacate the 41.18 zone. So, that's a good sign.
That's what we want. We want the police to come and clear out the sensitive areas, preferably without having some axe-wielding, mentally ill drug addict trying to attack the people or the other fellow homeless people over the drug arguments, etc. So yeah, that's kind of funny. Isn't that ironic? During our revitalization meeting, that's the problem there. So yep. That's good though, because I was just complaining about that before the meeting started. Okay, We're gonna go back into the Penmar Golf Course and Restaurant. We're at almost 11 here. I gotta assume Tracy Park will be here later for a presentation. Although I did hear a rumor that said she was currently with Mayor Karen Bass in Paris studying the Olympics, getting ready for the 2028 Olympics. I don't know if that's true, but we shall find out here. Okay. By the way, if you're enjoying the content of the Danny Slant channel, make sure to press that subscribe button, hit the notification bell, watch the videos, leave a comment, leave a like. It all helps with the YouTube algorithm. There's beautiful Penmar Park Golf Course here. Okay. That's a beautiful doggy and a beautiful. Is this your boy? Is this your dog? Oh, is it a boy or a girl?
What's her name?
What's her name?
There's another dog.
That's a little one over there. Okay, bye bye.
You start getting bombarded around election time.
This is more of my neighbors saying hello. Another good neighbor. Just want to say hello. They recognize me. I know them. You know, there's only a handful of people who roll up their sleeves.
He's the man, the eyes in the neighborhood.
I'm the Darren of the neighborhood. You know, the Karen's in the Darren. I'm one of the Darrens. But I actually still roll up my sleeves. And so does this man right here. There's a few times when we need a little neighborhood muscle to take care of some issues. You know which neighbors you can rely on.
Thank you.
Good seeing you. So, it turns out that Tracy Park is not making an appearance here, so all the neighbors did get a chance to come out and meet some of the staff members. They don't want to go on camera officially, make any official presentation. I understand that. Tracy is, in fact, in Paris right now with Mayor Karen Bass, with the coalition there, checking out the Olympics, getting prepared for the 2028 Olympics in LA. So, yeah, we're definitely going to have great Olympics. And again, if you enjoy the Olympics or if you enjoy the Danny Slant channel, make sure you smash that subscription button, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification, give a like, leave a comment. It's very important. If you enjoy it, to help support me, helps the YouTube algorithm. So, from Penmar Park, it's Danny Slant saying ciao ciao for now. Okay, rolling.
Hi, it's Pia. I'm here at the Penmar next to Penmar Park and the Venice Penmar Golf Course, and we're here for the Rose Avenue revitalization meeting. I just want to say it went really well. We're looking forward to these changes along Rose Avenue. A big shout out to the Tracy Park office and everyone involved in this project. Thank you so much. I think the neighborhood's going to see this wonderful project come to fruition soon.
Excellent. Thank you very much for saying that. And definitely we want to thank Tracy and her office for doing this here and the efforts and the time and planning this and having a beautiful path that'll be open again for all the residents like myself and Pia, so we can get back out there jogging, walking, running around and have something beautiful and sustainable. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for talking to me. And we'll say ciao, ciao for now.
Ciao.
Thank you. So I guess I'll have to be the bad guy. Remember Al Pacino in Scarface? You need a bad guy. I'm the bad guy. Look at me. So I'll be the bad guy here. I'm the neighbor who's going to talk about what's the issue that I really want to prevent, and that's the return of the tent and RV encampment on the Rose Avenue dirt jogging path. I get it. The city wants to maintain nice words. Rose Avenue revitalization, flora and fauna, plants, bushes, and we want to be very supportive of that. Yes, and we do. That's great. But I'm the guy who wants to make sure that doesn't come back. So yeah, I'll hold everybody accountable. I'll keep an eye on it. I'll keep documenting it because that's what I do. So, thanks for watching the Danny Slant channel. Remember, if you enjoy the channel, to hit the subscribe button. Hit the notifications bell. Hit a like, leave a comment, and watch the videos. Okay, from Penmar Park in beautiful, sunny Southern California, Venice Beach, California. It's Danny Slant saying, ciao, ciao for now. Bark, bark, with my bad wing getting better. Ciao, ciao.